is a women's bantamweight matchup between Liz Carmouche and Sara Mcmann. Training out of Revolution MMA in Gaffney, South Carolina, with the likes of Jimmy Fowler, Blake Grice, Phil Nurse, here is Sara Mcmann, perennial bantamweight contender. And for my money, this is as physically intimidating and imposing a bantamweight as there is in the women's division. The strength, certainly a big part of what she brings to the table on fight night.
This girl has a ridiculous chin. Her ability to take punishment is the stuff of legends. I have seen her take bombs and barely wins. She presses forward, and because of the fact that she has this incredible chin, she is able to stay in the pocket and land strikes on her opponent that maybe other fighters would never be able to get off.
Well, she made her UFC debut unforgettably against Ronda Rousey, UFC 157, February of 2013 in Anaheim, California. It was the first women's fight in UFC history, and Liz Carmouche nearly left that night as the UFC Women's Bantamweight Champion. She's still trying to get back to the top of the heap and has some momentum tonight, Joe. Big wins recently over Lauren Murphy, Caitlin Chookagian. Liz Carmouche proving still that she is still a force to be reckoned with at 135 pounds.
Liz Carmouche is an incredibly strong, relentlessly aggressive fighter who has devastating ground and pound and a very solid Brazilian jiu-jitsu game to go with it.
All right, just about ready for live action. Here is tonight's tale of the tape. Carmouche is 33. Mcmann is 37. The rest is nearly identical. We send it inside the octagon to Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this fight is three rounds in the UFC bantamweight division. If he was first, fighting out of the blue corner, a wrestler, holding a professional record of 11 wins, 5 losses. She stands 5 feet 6 inches tall, weighing in at 135 pounds. Fighting out of Gaffney, South Carolina, Sara Mcmann! And now introducing her opponent, fighting out of the red corner. This woman is a ballet judo fighter, only professional record of 11 wins, 6 losses. She stands 5 feet 6 inches tall, weighing in at 135 pounds. Fighting out of San Diego, California, USA, Liz Carmouche. The action begins. Referee in charge, Herb Dean.
Herb Dean, our third man in the octagon for this one.
Ready.
Well, it's a building that has hosted so many classic fights. We are underway at Madison Square Garden, right here in the heart of New York City. All right, here we go at the start of round one as we get another look at the former world title challenger, Liz Carmouche. She's seen it all, Joe. This is a savvy veteran. Few things could happen inside the octagon that would actually phase Carmouche. We'll see if she can get off to a good start tonight. Trying to stay heavy here as best she can. All right, first round is underway, and you better watch out for the overhand punches when you're fighting an opponent of this caliber. It really has become a patented punch of hers and something that a lot of opponents know is coming but still can't account for. Let's see how long it takes her to find her range here tonight. Getting the ground and pound going pretty good here early.
Excellent movement here on the ground. And now she's stacking her. And now she's in half guard.
Carmouche gets caught with that punch. Well, McMahon's hammer fist, that one blocked.
Full guard. Trying to spin to the back. Maintaining control. Excellent movement on the ground here. Constantly moving, constantly staying busy. Full back hooks. Excellent movement and transitions here on the ground. Staying busy.
McMahon gets caught with that punch.
She hit a nice sweep here and wound up on top in half guard. Postures up.
Trying to stay heavy here as best she can. Carmouche gets caught with that punch. Under a minute to go.
She's inside control. She's in the mounted crucifix now.
Oh, well placed with the hammer fist there by McMahon. So we cross the 30-second mark in our opening round.
Excellent movement here on the ground.
Oh, hammer fist here by McMahon.
Back to side control.
Round two is next.
Let's see some of the action here. And here's another clean shot that lands. And another perfectly placed strike.
Took a couple of punches, but that's all right. Let me look at that. Nothing.
Brittany Palmer here doing her thing as usual.
Ready to fight? Ready.
All right, round two. Carmouche gets caught with that punch. Got to shore up the defense here. Damaging punch lands for her there. Pushing forward with strikes. And now goes for the takedown. It's good.
Excellent movement on the ground here. Constantly moving, constantly staying busy. Big elbow. She's moved into side control.
Making all these shots count.
Into side control again. Working from the mounted crucifix. Excellent movement and transitions here on the ground. Staying busy. She's moved back to north-south again. Side control again. Oh, nasty elbow lands to the head. Now establish side control again.
Big body shot.
To body. She moves to the mounted crucifix. Big shot.
Trying to stay heavy here as best she can.
She's working for the mounted crucifix.
Oh, nice combination of ground and pound here by McMahon. Just over 2 minutes to go in round two. She's got as good an arsenal of chokes as anyone in the game. We'll see if she can set one up here.
She's got that choke locked in.
Oh, we're getting a finish here.
She might have to tap. This choke continues to get tighter. That's it.
There it is.
Got caught in the choke and didn't have the time to tap.
Yeah, so how about that, Joe? She goes to sleep, and you've got to admire her toughness for not wanting to tap out, but she just couldn't deal with the grappling acumen of her opponent here tonight. A beautiful setup and an even better display of technique to ultimately get the finish and put her opponent out for good.
Let's look at that again. And here we see it again. Beautiful submission victory.
Well, she couldn't have drawn it up any better than that as she gets the win by submission tonight. big win and an even bigger statement made to the rest of this division. We go back inside the octagon for the official decision. It resides with Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Herb Dean is going to stop to this contest at 3 minutes, 33 seconds of round number two. For the winner by submission, Sara
So there she is, following what could be argued as the biggest win of her career. She gets it done by submission here tonight. She told us during fight week, Joe, I gotta keep the judges out of it. She certainly did just that. Now all that's left to do is to celebrate with her coaches and her training partners. She had a lot of friends and family in the building here tonight. And man, did she put on a show for them and maximize this UFC showcase. Congratulations.
Ain't that what I gave you last week? Yeah. You done it now. Feels like I'm coming up and spit it like I'm underground. Wonder how I come into your city like I run a town. Let it sound. Started on the stage, now we in the crowd. Yeah, we split the hype though. Told me that your record was the greatest, but you lied though. Told me they consider you a god, yeah, we're like don't. Say you never live until you find something to die for. Yeah, and then it's so true. Forget the haters, remember people you're close to. Now I'm doing things they told me I ain't supposed to. They treat me like a player, that's funny, I'm here to coach you.